Big thanks go out to Bloom Nutrition for sponsoring today's video.
He's my girl. Whose girl is this? It's my girl.
Hi. Hi, Bubs. Okay, so immediately I hit the ground, right? And then you want to join. She was napping in the background. I was like, oh, we're going to have a cute dog nap in the background. Nope. Front and center. Front and center. This is Callie, for those who haven't kept up in the last year's festivities. We've almost had her for a full year. We adopted her last May. Last May. And she's very excited because she's been watching me clean, which is what we're doing. And I basically told myself that the hardest part of vlogging is literally starting. It's like going to gym. Like, the hardest part is going to the gym. So we aren't really going for aesthetic because she ain't a vlogger anymore. I do this like once or twice a year to remind myself I still can do it. And also, you know, appease my loyal vlog viewers who miss my second channel that is not making a comeback, as I always say. So I am just recovering from a trip, our yearly trip to Colorado, and I'm just restocking the dog's food. It was dead silent before I sat down and started talking. Bubby Boo, go crate. Good girl, good girl. I'm unpacking all the dog's bags from grandparents' house, basically, like where they were while we were out of town. I just need to move everything back into the correct bins. And you guys can see a quick shot of their food situation. Very proud of the recent Target bins I've added. You know, I'm a sucker for organization, and I love sections for everything. So we have like wet food for them. And then their kibble bins are these gigantic big white bins that you probably barely can see over the cabinet, but let's just hope for the best. And I'm using an external mic that's attached to me. So hopefully this vlog sounds a little different. And it also gives me that flexibility of kind of like walking around and getting stuff done. Cause that's what we're doing. We're getting stuff done. This is an awkward angle even for me because this box probably can be removed and I just don't like removing it. Grab that. So now as I put everything back, you might hear a little one whining a bit. She's actually about to go to her grooming appointment. Yuna, our older dog, went to hers yesterday, but the way scheduling worked out, audible dog drinking water. How on brand. She ended up going yesterday because of our groomer schedule. So she's heading out in less than 30 minutes and we're gonna try to really get some stuff done. Ugh, energy drink. Ugh. Really need this, like we are feeling all the burnout of returning home. All the acrylic bins are from Bright Room at Target. This bin is for all of their dog enrichment things that you may have seen on my Instagram and TikTok, and their slow feeders. So I gave myself an excuse to get more. I got a big bin. And then I have smaller bins for the different type of wet food and their lick mats. It's probably gonna get their own individual bin in a little bit, but it's just not that. So now, so there's like wet food pouches. And I was just kind of test fitting things with some things to have stickers on it just in case, but it seems like they fit. And then we have two of these Yamakaze home dog food bins. What are you doing? Well, come here. These have the silicone on the outside, so it's great to keep it fresh, but we also keep it in the bag. Yuna actually eats the kibble, like the Hill's urinary care diet after she had a kidney stone surgery, but Callie also just has the same bag. We have so many of the bags, and the bags are just like perfect fit, so we just refill her kibble into it as well. And they just fit perfectly, and we can open them, and this slides out, and they come with these little scoops, and the scoops get every last little drop. You'll see it on my Instagram if you really want to see more, but these are linked off on my Amazon as well. These are the largest. I know there's extra large, but they fit in this cabinet, and this is like the doggy cabinet. So let's go find a dog. I found one. What's up, kid? Face. What you doing? Why are you so upset? I'm trying to get her to eat these like treat residues out of this Insta crate because it spilled on the way back from grandma and grandpa's, but no, she won't. So I have to actually wipe it down, waste the treatos. I was gonna dump them out on the floor, but it's really just like dust and crumbs, and that's just gonna be excessively worse when they fall out. Here's a few big chunkas. Big chunkas, okay. And just... Oof. All right, a quick little breakfast. Wouldn't hurt. I recently got the cast iron version of my Always pan, which is pretty loved. I'm kind of in the midst of wanting to revamp my pots and pans. Like, I like my Our Place ones. I know some people say they're overhyped. Could be true depending on what you're cooking. I don't disagree. I always get them when they're on sale. We're about to make some soup dumplings. But I do like all the accessories they have. Like, I think that's kind of like where they have me. And of course, I love the color. Personally, I don't really like my caraway pans. I think those are overhyped. Like, I like this little steamer basket with little inserts, and I think that's pretty cool. My caraway set is probably going on Facebook Marketplace soon because I can't, apologies, speed boost is really loud. I can't really use it for what the best features are of it, which is that the pot lids are mounted on your wall. It doesn't work in any of my cabinets because my cabinets are like standard and they don't fit. You can't close it with that. Oh, I gotta defrost my sea moss. I'm on a sea moss kick. Like, I'm new to it, so. Peach is the flavor of the week. Got it like locally. I'm gonna let that thaw out. Put it on a coaster. These coasters are awesome. Here we are. They're silicone. Also on my Amazon, have a little lip, catch all the condensation. We're all over the place, I'm aware. The caraway lids don't get mounted. I can't keep the pots and pans in their cool little separator dividers because that doesn't fit as well. So like, I just have all these accessories and now just like heavy pots and pans that don't particularly impress me in any way. And I feel like I like these other pots and pans on Amazon a little bit more. So I might just sell my caraway set, maybe during this vlog. We're gonna get our dumplings. We're gonna put our dumplings in. They are not breaking apart, but Bibigo soup dumplings, pork and ginger. Bibigo anything is great, but their soup dumplings are good, and their japchae dumplings that are like rectangular, I love those in the air fryer. These are all like stuck together. There's like three more, like F it, just eat them, right? I can't break them apart. Nope, just a few are broken apart now. Got the pairs of three, and we need a new bag of soup dumplings. So once the water boils, we'll be all set. Okay, so the dumplings are almost done, and I wanted to quickly wash out these two vases, so I have them soaking in soap and water. I've been trying to keep fresh flowers in the house this year from Trader Joe's, you know, a little affordable Trader Joe's moment. I also have tulips growing in the garden, and my daffodils have already bloomed, so I might refill them with some daffies today, depending on how it is. It's really gloomy and like outside today, so I don't know if I really want to go out, but this is my favorite vase right now because all flowers look so good with it. It's a ceramic vase that looks like a paper bag, so it's giving, you know, cottage core but Amazon. And then this isn't from Amazon. My bestie gave me this one, but I'm sure I could find it on Amazon. That one just looks good for most flowers and need a little support. So I have those kind of like chilling because the flowers you may have seen earlier in the video, which were tulips, I got them right before our trip, and tulips only last like a week or some change, like a week and a half. So they were on the way out. The new flowers need to be on the way in. I've been working with my therapist to kind of like, you know, work through things because we all have things. And one of the goals this year on my like 2023 mood board is to just get myself fresh flowers when I feel like it. Weekly is a thing, but I don't need to structure myself as weekly. Like, I don't have to earn it. I don't have to feel like I'm worth it. I can just get myself some $5 flowers because they make me happy when I see them. So do something that makes you happy this week and excuse this situation behind me. Usually this is all clean and there's an air fryer and it's just pretty aesthetic, minimal, and I like that. But right now we have husband's bottle and my post-surgery setup in two empty containers because I needed to remind myself that we needed bread, so I left the bread container out. But we just came back from a trip, so you know, fridge is empty, all the perishables were eaten, etc., etc. I have my distilled water, my nasal rinses, I have a bunch of different like things I have to do for a month post-sinus surgery. For those who have been following, I have like lidocaine mouthwash. They call it magic mouthwash, and like steroids that have to go into here. So it's all just been sitting here because I have to do it daily until my new air fryer comes, because my air fryer got recalled and they told me to cut the cord and they'll send a new one. So the new one's on the way, but like I missed my air fryer. But luckily the dumplings are about ready. Oh no. How will the last ones fit? As you can see, lunch is served and my sea moss is the frosting. I honestly don't know if this works at all either, so I'm not like here to preach anything at you guys. I'm just trying it out and I'm only like on my first month, but my hairstylist said it was actually pretty good, like taste wise. So I got it from the same vendor in Maryland, which is called Mad Moss. We gave like a lot of samples, which was cool when we did a pickup order, but it's supposed to be like rich in iron, helps with thyroid stuff, you know, curves hunger, anti-inflammatory, all that stuff, right? But obviously you just want to taste like fruit or anything else. And I have like really bad acid reflux and such like that, so at least that helps me in the morning when I take a spoonful. It's better than Tums all the time. So we'll see. I really don't know, but I'm gonna take my strawberry melon prime energy because she's tired, and my dumplings, and we're gonna go eat while we get some work done, because what's resting? This man actually never can keep his own stuff to his station, no matter how big of a station I make it. It's always on my desk. I think it's part of his affection. But now you see him. Ta-da! All right. I really, really like my new desk setup. So I have a few things out that aren't usually out, which are like keycaps, because you'll see me working on my new keyboard. I just wanted to do just a little bit of modification on my keyboard for this setup. But if you don't follow me on my other socials, this used to be just a plain, same desk. Like, I've had this desk for over 5 years, but it just had an iMac on it, an older iMac that is 10 years old now, which is fine. But for me, I needed something a little bit more. So I have a Samsung monitor now, which has this little like remote. And then I have a mini Mac plugged into it. So I can use Mac on my Samsung monitor because I am a Mac girl, I edit. So we're gonna have lunch real quick and then we're gonna work on this keyboard together. And one of my favorite parts about my desk is my new privacy screen. It's basically the boho version of my favorite streamer, Sykuno. If you've ever seen any of his streams, he has a black version of this, but I love it. It's really slim. My dryer is done, but it allows me to kind of zone out, go cubicle mode. If I really want to grind my workout, I can do this, and my husband can still walk around it. As you can see, like, it's open right there. I can block it off fully if I want to, but sometimes it's not about like not seeing my husband. It's me getting overstimulated and sometimes distracted easily. So I like zone out like this, because sometimes he has a lot of like colors going on his monitor. He's playing a game, et cetera, et cetera. It's not even a noise thing because I don't care about that. It's more like visually, like I get real distracted. So that part's really nice. He's actually, you know, obviously not home right now. He took the dog to the groomers, but this just feels good. Aside from aesthetic, this is my new setup. And of course I have a blankie, and this blankie is actually the dog's blankie. So we are gonna work on my new keyboard together. This is my first build. Like, I've only used stock keyboards, which is not a big deal. I'm not a big mechanical girl either, because I've been a Mac user majority of my life, and I've always just used whatever comes with the Mac. And this is what it comes stock looking like. I wanted one that had a knob that I could change later and such. So let's do this together. All right, let's speed this up just a little bit. So as you can see, the top row has already been switched. I did this last night with my daughter just to make sure I like the feel of things. And these are the original yellow switches that come with it. These are what they look like side by side. This part sucks. Removing these switches, not fun.
not fun at all. Compared to removing the caps, you have to use this little prong on this side to take each out versus using this side. I'm gonna give you guys, of course, some satisfying clips, and just know that it wasn't as satisfying for me. So now that the switches are on, we can do the fun part, which is very aesthetically pleasing. I got these keycaps from Amazon. You can also find them on Etsy. I just found them to be a quicker arrival and a little cheaper on Amazon. So I decided to go with a gradient vibe, which is my tones. The funny part is this is like two levels in this box, and for some reason it was upside down when I took it off my shelf and it looked more like this. Okay, realistically, this is frustrating because they're all upside down now. The box is the same on both sides. Very much struggle bus, and you can hear by my reaction, I was unhappy.
You can help me put stuff away if you want to. So would you like to say hi to the camera?
Hi.
This is Mia. For those who have not met Mia, Mia is how old now?
Nine.
Turning?
10.
Wonderful. And she's in her pajamas.
Mm-hmm.
And just got here from her dad's house. We gotta put the stuff away before the dogs want out of their crates. We got some Trader Joe's stuff, and I did Amazon Fresh order. The one bad thing with Amazon Fresh, which we do a lot of our grocery shopping there, is that they sometimes bag it really weird. You know where these go. Would you like to help too, Aves, or you're not feeling up for it right now? You're good? You gonna watch the dogs for me? Wonderful. Ave, do you wanna fold these for me? Fold them flat. So I got these for neighbor time tonight. So they just need to go into the fridge. I got lemonade, and I figured if we're doing breakfast for dinner, this makes a lot of sense. Yeah, totally fine, so you just lay it down. You do that? You got it? Wonderful. I got you a few of these. There's the empty, you see the empty thing on the left? Yep. This is bread. So this goes into that big, you see the big tall tube thing with the white lid? Thank you, Mia. Wonderful. Mommy's happy juice. I'll be honest, our fridge has looked a little better. But since most of the stuff's gonna be eaten tonight at, you know, neighbor time, it's kind of like, we'll see what's left before Mommy busts out any more containers. I gotta make these cinnamon rolls. Lovely. Earlier, I went to Nothing Bundt Cakes to pick up a dozen Bundtinis for Chris's birthday celebration. We hang out with our neighbors every Saturday. We call it neighbor time, and we kind of alternate what house we're at. One of the three houses, we are one of the three, count us in. We're the middle house, actually. One of the houses is out of town right now, so the real celebration is probably gonna be next week, but Chris's birthday is in 2 days. So you guys get like a birthday weekend, post-trip, vloggy situation. All right, so the doggies are gonna get impatient in a second, but luckily, I got doggy treats. That was one of the few things I needed to get at Trader Joe's, because they have some great, like, just single protein treats. So, like, they really like these. So I'm gonna give the kids a bag of these to give them while they are in their crate. Here's the other one for whichever dog that Mia is not giving them to. And then they also, oh crap, this is not the right one. I wanted the salmon skins, but this was facing the opposite way and I saw it like that, but it is salmon jerky. They'll eat it, it's fine. I've been advised that my head is cut off, so aside from aesthetics, no problem. Oh, I got you guys these to try.
Yeah, I tried the jellyfish.
PB and C, so they're wafers and you dip it in peanut butter, chocolate wafer. Do you wanna try one? First impression? Okay. It's new, you know, when Trader Joe sucks you in with something new. Yeah. Come.
I saw the single version of the jelly.
Don't open everything with your teeth.
This is peanut butter, this is cream.
No, this is, that's peanut butter, and this is chocolate.
Chocolate, okay.
Okay, let's see. I think you have to kind of scoop like that. Yeah, scoop. Scoop is the way, not stab.
Tastes good.
Tastes good?
There's even peanut butter inside of it.
Mmm. I don't think so. I think the peanut butter got inside there.
Hmm? Yeah.
Flour-wise today, couldn't figure out what color I wanted. Last time, I got white and purple thinking I would just do alternate. Usually I stick to my white, so I stick to one color. Me and my overstimulation. I love to keep things simple. But I was kind of wanting to try a little like sunset-y red situation. I thought they were pretty, but then I realized like some of them are kind of jacked up, like they got kind of crushed. But then I am too socially anxious to go switch them out. So that's what we got today. I'm gonna do one with a mix of white and red, and then the glass one's just gonna have red. Thank you. So we're back, and I'm not sure if the hair is hairing, but I hope a little bit of it lasts for tomorrow since we have brunch at 11:30 in the morning. And usually if I have a good air wrap day, it lasts for a few days. Like I did it right before our Colorado trip and I barely had to refresh it. I think I did like one day refresh and it's like 5 or 10 minutes. So hopefully there's at least some shape to it compared to flat and soggy looking. Brought you back to my desk to kind of show you those just final like full view with the desk. I like it a lot. I am overall happy with how it came out. I still have to do all my cable management, so you'll just see some cables right now. I have a little bit of cable management going, but other stuff I kind of need to drill into my desk. So that's not done yet. But just to break down the pricing and just my overall experience, I think it would have been a lot more fun if I wasn't filming because the lighting kept changing so much and I wanted to film for YouTube and like TikTok. And it was just like a lot of like, oh, now my phone's dying, you know, just technical filming error and stress. Plus I'm using a new mic. So that was definitely something. Let me know if you think I should change the knob to gold or rose gold. I was originally gonna make it gold because I have little gold points on my desk, like my laptop stand and such like that, but I don't know, like the white kind of is a vibe with the base as well. That is the before. So it is 1 p.m. right now and neighbor time is at 5 and we are not hosting at our house tonight. But in between, I want to find some time to just vibe out without the camera, decompress on my couch. Maybe I'll throw it on, who knows, we'll see. Get some lunch because that's my balance of the self-care and such. And since we're already here, I'll give you guys a little glimpsey poo at my husband's upcoming setup for his desk. It is not done because it's missing his monitor riser, which is like this, but that's like being custom made, so it's not here yet. And then we have another picture coming. Anyone who has dealt with a man will understand what I mean by he was totally happy with his setup until I refreshed mine. I thought he could utilize the space better, like function even over form. So we will be having like kind of like a sped up version on my Instagram eventually, and you'll see kind of the before. But we did like a IKEA combo. He wanted a black and white theme, and it's gonna go really well with these photos of the doggos. So I have one being made for Callie from the same people. This is like a lasered out sticker situation with her face. And that's gonna be nice. That's gonna go there. Callie's gonna have one. And then those are actually light bars and we just got a second set. So we're gonna kind of do like a frame in with them. And it really warms up the space when those lights are on. I put his guitar on the wall because it just was like laying on the floor all the time and that kind of drove me nuts. And then he has a gigantic monitor behind me, but this is only one. He's missing one. He's missing one over here. But there is an arm already in his speaker setup. But this space is all fun. So we maximized as much of this corner as possible for him. And there's still, you know, a lot of like aesthetic touches to be had, but this is gonna be the work from home side and this is the play and fun side. Like he has a whole like steering wheel set up underneath him with pedals. And then this area, like he'll have all the leg room he needs when he brings his stuff home from work. Some weekends they send him home with like laptops and monitors and stuff that he has to, you know, sit here and work at night. Truly, like the dogs are taking a nap. I think I deserve a nap, but I'm starving. First world problems. But you can see how dark that corner is without all the lights and light bar changes. And it's way more warm and cozy later. So I'm happy with how the progress is progressing. Otherwise, the only other change would be the kids' room. They have new desks as well. They have new IKEA desks. They've been upgraded from their original desk. Their house bed used to have this like just lip desk. And it was great for 2020 when they had school full time, you know, virtual schooling. And it was perfect for that, but now they're bigger and now they're gaming and now they need like desk. So they have full like, I think they're called like Mickey desk, I forgot what they're called, like Alex desk. And Mia just got hers recently. So Ava has my old iMac setup, which is funny. And just a nice way to kind of repurpose my 10-year-old computer. She's like playing Valorant on it and doing her thing. And then we're gonna get Mia like a setup of her own as well. So she can do all her graphic design coloring activities because she's really into kind of the arts and that creative aspect. So yeah, for those who really miss seeing us, that's what we got. Thank you.
Aside from the tragic mess from this gigantic donut that's all over me, look how big this damn cinnamon roll is. What in the hell is happening in Colorado?